In this Adobe Premiere and After Effects tutorial, I'm going to show you how you can replace a clip in Adobe Premiere with an After Effects composition, have it dynamically linked with After Effects, so any changes that you make in After Effects automatically update in Adobe Premiere, and make this process reversible. Usually when you replace a clip with an After Effects composition in Adobe Premiere, there's not an easy way to go back. But if you take a few steps in the beginning, you can easily undo the process. Here I have a mocked up project in my timeline on Adobe Premiere. I want to use the Roto Brush on this clip in the beginning. There's no Roto Brush option in Adobe Premiere, so I need to replace this clip with an After Effects composition. If I right-click and select Replace with After Effects Composition, it will create an After Effects project, allow you to name it, and save it in the same file as your Premiere project. Then it will automatically open the After Effects project. Here I can simply make edits in After Effects. If I want to use the Roto Brush on this clip, I can double-click the layer, mark with the Roto Brush. Then I can also use the Refine Edge tool. Then if I propagate the frames with the Roto Brush tool, After Effects renders the frames and everything is rotoed out. I can click Freeze and After Effects will freeze these frames by rendering the frames out for the Roto Brush. This is a good way to speed up the processing for After Effects and to save your work. Once the frames are frozen, save your After Effects project, then go back to Adobe Premiere. Inside Adobe Premiere, we'll notice that the clip is now red. That's showing that there's a dynamic link between After Effects, and we can see the effect applied right here in Adobe Premiere. We can go back into After Effects and make any changes to this. Problem is, it's difficult to undo this. Even though we can go back into After Effects and make changes, we have lost our original clip. Sure, we can bring our clip back in, but what if we've made lots of edits and different changes in Adobe Premiere that we want to be able to go back to? It's always best to work non-destructively, so I'll show you a better way to do this. I'll bring in the original clip, and this time I'll make an edit, so it's not as easy to replace. So this clip is a different length, and it could be an important decision that I made with editing. Instead of immediately right-clicking and replacing with an After Effects composition, you can hold Alt or Option and duplicate the clip. Leave the original clip below, and then on the top clip, right-click and replace with an After Effects composition. This will do the same process. It will open it up in the After Effects project that you have. But now after I save this and go back to Premiere, I still have this red dynamically linked After Effects clip. But what if I messed up? I can always either delete it or hide it. Now I have a reversible dynamic clip. But what if you have multiple clips? It's not just a single clip and you don't want to keep duplicating and keeping a complicated timeline. Another way to make replace with an After Effects composition reversible in Adobe Premiere is to select multiple clips, right-click, nest the clips, label your nested sequence. This creates a nested sequence, kind of like a folder in Adobe Premiere. Then we can see it over here in our project panel. This time, right-click the nested sequence in the timeline. Select Replace with After Effects Composition. Now we have the entire clip inside After Effects with edits and everything. We can make changes to this clip, then save our After Effects project. Go back to Adobe Premiere. This is now a dynamically linked After Effects composition. If we don't want this dynamically linked After Effects composition, we can always bring back in our nested clip. So I can drag my nested clip back and it contains all the clips I had. I can either leave it as a nested sequence or I can double click inside the sequence and make edits here. If I only need to replace a single clip, often just duplicating the clip above it and replacing that clip in After Effects is a good workflow. But if you have multiple clips, it can be good to nest a sequence in Premiere before replacing with a clip in After Effects. It's always best practice to make your rough edit first. That way you're not doing any special effects or compositing on footage you're not going to use. It'll keep your timeline cleaner and make it easier to undo. When you want to work non-destructively in Adobe Premiere and After Effects with dynamic links, make sure you either duplicate the footage first or use nested sequences. That way you can always undo your dynamic links with Adobe Premiere and After Effects. Happy video editing!